I had to start with walking my dogs on a lead, like every responsible person would. And eventually I got to a place where I thought, let me just try them without the lead. So just before we got home, I would let them loose and they would be able to run, but I'd call them and see if they actually listened. And when I knew they could listen, I would actually go just with one lead and I would walk the dogs without a lead. Yes, there will be some moms saying, I gather it wasn't for me. There'll be some moms saying that it's irresponsible with the dogs. I go early in the morning. So when I leave home, I know what time I'm leaving, and I know if I'm going to go on a short walk or a long walk, depending on what actually my day holds. So we're normally out very early in the mornings, and I have to watch the dogs. So I watch that they don't try and eat the food that's lying around. I watch that they don't run down the wrong streets, that they don't run in the road. I know where the big intersections are. So I'm constantly watching the dogs, and I know where the gates are with the dogs, and I can see the gates opening if there's people that are leaving and the dogs are running out. If my dogs don't listen to me, they can land up on the street. Eventually you'll land up in a pack. Maybe they wouldn't last very long. I mean, those pretty dogs, wherever they are, I mean, look at them, they're not exactly killers. They're not gonna be killing for food. So there's safety at home. So they leave the safety of home and they go into the unknown world with me being able to watch them. Okay, so none of this is going to make any difference if I don't point to Jesus and the scripture. So there's Galatians 5. Marky, I'm going to read it for you. You, my brothers and sisters, are called to be free. But do not use your freedom to indulge in the flesh. Rather serve one another humbly in love. For the entire law is fulfilled in keeping with this one command. Love your neighbor as yourself. If you bite and devour each other, watch out or you'll be destroyed by each other. Okay, yeah, this is where I'm going. But I wanted to read the whole piece so that's not completely out of context. So I say to you, walk by the Spirit and you'll not be gratifying the desires of the flesh. For the flesh desires what is contrary to the Spirit, and the Spirit what is contrary to the flesh. They are in conflict with each other, so that you will not do whatever you want. But if you are led by the Spirit, you are not under the law. So, what does it look like to walk with Holy Spirit? Holy Spirit knows where He's going to take you. There's safety. He knows where the big intersections are in your life. Are you going to be running into traffic, running with the wrong people? He knows where you shouldn't be, how you should be. There's a understanding that He is supposed to be walking with us all the time. How do we do this? So start small. Start with the little stuff. Start reading the scripture. Just small stuff. Don't try and do a half an hour if you've never done it before. Take a passage of scripture, but be diligent. Don't just jump around in scripture. Ask Holy Spirit what He's saying about that scripture for you today. And pray. Yes, the old songs when you were in Sunday school, it said, read your Bible, pray every day. I don't remember the words to it. Yeah, I can see you remember the words. You want to sing it for us? No? Okay. But if you aren't walking with the Holy Spirit, you're missing out. You're missing out on what actually is going to be the next step. Are you going to be in the right place? Are you going in the right direction? Are you going to be home in time? Is there safety? Is He going to be taking care of you? The answer is yes. But if Jesus isn't in your life and you haven't been given the Holy Spirit because He died for the mere fact that the Holy Spirit was given to us. So He came to earth, He died for our sins to send the Holy Spirit. That's the passage of it. So you've got to be able to be walking with the Holy Spirit to enjoy this comfort, this peace, this hope, this joy. I hope that makes sense to you. Enjoy your morning.